A good tip is to go from above and get lots of light.
Who maybe even now doesn't get his due as far as an individual. You know, Fred is another very important figure who maybe even now doesn't get his due as far as individually his artistic talents or even, you know, people talk about him in that way. They sort of remember him more after he crossed over to television and, you know, Yo and MTV. But, I mean, Fred was really the guy that did the soup cans. You know, Fred did the soup cans on the subway trains back then, and, like, you know, he was the one that was clever enough to make that association between what we were doing and what the art world was doing. And he was the one that really instrumented us coming above ground, hooking up at the Mud, Nick Grill, Roxy, his knowledge of the scene from uptown, you know, his blackness, you know, just being who he was and being able to also be an MC rapper. I mean, he was a sort of a jack of all trades kind of guy back then, and someone who I had like enormous respect for, because really he was my mentor in a sense of like how, you know, like we say now, like, yo, put me on, you know, tell me what's up, and he definitely did that, you know. So I don't get to hang with Fred enough, and I don't, maybe I didn't like big him up enough, but I think Fred is a certainly important guy for me, because in that beginning period of PS1 and when we were in the art scene, like, we shared a studio, and, you know, it's like the making of Wild Style, Fred Brathwaite, Charlie Ahern, you know, I mean, the whole scene, Henry Martha, Star Wars, Subway Arts, Breakdown Art, you know, all of the historical legacies that, you know, all of those people who are so influential in making it part of history, you know, because if it would have been up to me, I would have had no photos of anything, very few memories, you know, and I wouldn't have had that sort of mindset like those guys did. I mean, I think Fred made the crossover really possible, more than any other one person, you know, and then, you know, you look, like I say, at the diversity of what he did. So, you know, my own personal legacy, where I'm at right now in the year 2002, you know, and we're talking about 20 years ago now, you know, I think it's amazing. Good drug stories aside.
So, you're the one responsible for me getting fired.
I know, yeah.
For the Daily News, partially.
Well, I got Madonna kicked out of her apartment also in East Village. You heard that one, right?
Yeah.
Tell us that one.
Oh, come on.
I heard the story about you and Madonna at the Roxy.
No way. Under the bleachers? You heard that story? That's not true, Steve. That's absolutely not true. But I did get her kicked out of her apartment, I think, because when the rage was on, you know, and people were kind of like, hey, can you paint my space?
At the moment, I'm actually painting a lot, which is quite new, really, and working with ceramic sculpture.